Blackstone Audiobooks presents Heart of a Lion by Gilbert Morris. The following dedication appears in the book. To Dr. Daniel Grant, there are many scholars in this old world of ours, and there are many spiritual men, but only rarely do scholarship and warm spirituality exist in the same individual. When I think of the handful of believers who manifest a marriage of heart and brain, the name Dan Grant is at the top of my list. Thank you, Dr. Grant, for being what you are, and for being a friend to me when I sorely needed one. Prologue. The sun's white disk still burned brightly in the sky as it settled toward the western horizon. A solitary figure knelt on a promontory of yellow sandstone that jutted out over the valley, his hands lifted reverently toward the heavens. The heavy silence that had cloaked the landscape was pierced by his trumpet-like voice. At the disturbance, a flock of ibis rose like a cloud from the valley floor, melded into a single image above the river, spiraled upward on invisible thermals, then disappeared into the dusky air.
O ancient one, maker of all things, I offer thanks for your might and your power. By your hand is the river filled so that the land will bear fruit. By your voice the seeds burst into life. The sun and the moon, yes, and all the starry lights are the work of your mighty hand.
The voice of Zora, the seer, flowed over the valley below, rising and falling in its musical cadence and echoing off the canyon walls before falling silent. The wise one held his arms aloft, as still as a candle in a crypt, as immovable as the hills at his back. He stayed in this position while the sun's white brilliance faded to a blood-red glow, sinking lower and lower until a mere crescent of crimson fire balanced on the lacy branches of distant trees. When ebony darkness had swallowed the earth, Zora lifted his voice again, this time in a hoarse whisper of desperation.
O ancient one, I cannot hear your voice. Be not silent to me, I beg. Speak in my heart as you have in times of old.
The seer's plea died on the silent air. His thin frame began to sway like a sapling in a strong wind. With eyes squeezed shut, his mouth gaped open, gulping in the life-giving air like a fish gasping for breath on dry land. Then he heard it. His ears perked up in the darkness, his heart listening in rapt recognition to a voice. A still, small voice that had first addressed him when he was but a stripling. Hear my word, faithful one. Remember how I once said to you, go to the clan of Lamech, and you obeyed me. You watched as the male child was born, and you cut the cord yourself. You spoke the words I gave you for Lamech and his wife. This man-child shall comfort you concerning your work and the toil of your hands. The voice ceased, and Zora cried, O ancient one, I did obey, that I have kept watch over the child.
But what would you have me do now?
I have chosen Noah to be my servant, even as I chose you. You have been faithful, and now I will show you what is to come. Tell no one, but keep the young man, Noah, from harm. The voice ceased, and Zora heard a rushing wind. His frail body trembled first at the noise, then at the frightful vision that rose before him, illuminating the darkness with images more terrible than he could have imagined. He knew he could tell no man of it, yet neither would he ever forget the sight.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.